So welcome back to my channel, 305 Producers here. And today, as I promised, we're going to set up with Fruity Loop the Wordy Panda Mini Keyboard Controller. If you missed my previous video unboxing this guy, you can check here in the notes in the corner of the screen. Go there, click and watch my unboxing video. I did an unboxing as well as the headphones and the audio interface. So today we are going to set up this keyboard controller, the MIDI keyboard controller, to the Fruity Loop. The first thing we need to do, it comes with this USB cable. You connect this end to the USB port of the computer or the laptop computer, whatever you have. And in this end over here, it has another port. You don't need an extra source of power because it powers by the computer. So we connect this over here. Let's connect it. Okay, as you can see, it's already on. If you press, it's gonna work. Now we need to set something here, especially the velocity of the keys, because when you connect this guy for the first time, when you press a key, it's not going to sound like that. You need to press really hard to hear it really loud. You don't want to press that hard, you're gonna break the keys. You don't want that to happen. So let's go into the screen of my computer to show you what we need to do to change the velocity. And that's very important. Let's go. So once we are here in Fruity Loop, the first thing we need to do is go to Options, go to MIDI Settings, and here we, in Input, we see the Wordy, which is the MIDI controller. What we need to do is selected already by default. What we need to do is go to Enable, and now this is the most important part. Let's change the velocity. The velocity, we go here. By default, when you install it the first time, it's going to be like this. Now all we need to do is go to this little point over here and bring it up all the way up like this. We click accept. Now, as you can see, as soon as you touch the key to the pads, it responds. Now we close here, and another important thing that we need to do is go here, go to audio settings, and here we choose this one over here. Let me close and go back a little bit. Usually we can be in one of these inputs here, or maybe you are in ASIO 4v2. You just go here, clip here, and by default it's going to be in 512. All we need to do is go to 256. And what that does is, as soon as you touch the key, it will respond immediately. And that's all we need to do to set up and connect our MIDI keyboard controller. In the next video, I am going to show you how to record beats and samples in Fruity Loop Studio. Stay tuned. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, I don't know what's going on with my English today, please do, and click on the notifications bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. See you in the next one.